What conversations have you had with Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman?
I don't know those gentlemen.
You're in pictures
with them. Now, it's possible I have a picture with them because I have a picture with everybody. I have a picture with everybody here. But somebody said there may be a picture or something where at a fundraiser or somewhere. But I have pictures with everybody.
Have you talked with them?
I don't know if there's anybody I don't have pictures with. I don't know them. I don't know about them. I don't know what they do. But I don't know. Maybe they were clients of Rudy. You'd have to ask Rudy. I just don't know.
I don't know anything about the crimes they commit for my personal lawyer, Rudy, when they go to Ukraine and chase people. I don't know. I'm like, I'm in pictures with them. We hug. They know my kid. But I don't know them. So that moment where the president sought to distance himself from those two men, Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman, might not have worked out for Donald Trump. Parnas and Fruman were associates of Rudy Giuliani in their work with him, assisting him in efforts to dig up dirt on the Bidens, pushing to oust Ukrainian Ambassador Marie Yovanovitch, lies at the heart of Donald Trump's impeachment. Parnas and Fruman, who were indicted last month for campaign finance violations by the Southern District of New York, had previously ignored the subpoenas they received from House impeachment investigators. But after that diss from Donald Trump, I hardly knew ye, I have pictures with everybody, including you people in the media, that made one of them change his mind. In the wake of that epic presidential diss, Lev Parnas is now willing to cooperate with Congress. His reasoning, apparently no one puts Lev in the corner. His lawyer tells the New York Times, quote, Mr. Parnas was very upset by President Trump's plainly false statement that he didn't know him. His lawyer expanded to the Washington Post saying this, quote, any sentient being looking at the public record of the president and Parnas together during intimate dinners, waving to each other at rallies, taking pictures together. And if Parnas's alleged involvement with the president's lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, could divine that the president and Parnas knew each other. Everyone's back. Yeah. Eugene.
Well,
it's like Shakespearean.
You know, I mean, you know, one of the questions I have is, does Parnas's willingness to cooperate with the impeachment inquiry mean that he has flipped, basically, and that he is going to cooperate with the Southern District of New York in hopes of more lenient treatment? I don't know if against Mr. Fruman or against others, against Mr. Giuliani, perhaps. So that may be the who knows what the more momentous sort of angle of this is. He might have something to tell the impeachment inquiry that it really wants to know. But he may have something to say to the law.
So Hyland, I'm just struck that these are like criminals around the president. So Roger Stone, is on trial today. Paul Manafort is here. Like, I worked in politics a long time. I've never known any elected officials to have so many criminals in their inner circle.
And a couple of obvious, like two-bit thugs like those guys, Lev and Igor, like it's kind of a, it's a joke, right?
Yeah.
Eugene's being more circumspect than I'd be. would you like me to speculate?
Please.
I think that the president, at this point, if you're thinking about who the president really has to be worried about, like, who are you nervous about if you're Donald Trump, genuinely? You're worried about Rudy. I'm worried about Rudy. Because the truth is that if Rudy flipped on the president down this path, on this front, just on this thing, on the question of what happened in Ukraine, if Rudy were under pressure and flipped on the president would be really hosed. And so I asked the question about, to Eugene's point, I think Lev and Igor are under a lot of pressure to provide information about everything that they did on behalf of Rudy Giuliani, which was on behalf of Donald Trump. And I think that the way in which what investigators will want to do is try to roll those two guys up and try to then go to Giuliani and say, Giuliani, you have some criminal exposure here. The way in which you'd alleviate your criminal exposure is to have a conversation about all of the work you were doing on behalf of the President of the United States, some of which might have been illegal. This is a really significant, potentially significant thing in both political terms and in legal terms, the notion that one of these two obvious Russian henchmen has flipped on Rudy.
Let's stay with this, because Rudy is under investigation by the Southern District of New York for the corrupt lobbying practices. And a window into his defense, we've already seen it. He holds up his phone and he says, Mike Pompeo and his State Department told me to do it. Yeah. We've already seen Rudy's defense and we already know where it's going to go down. It's going to go down on Fox News with one of his devices he bangs on in a way that makes me wince. he's not going down for this. He is not going down for this.
No, he's not. And when he's waving that phone around, that phone, he's waving that phone at the president of the United States.
Yeah, he is.
He's reminding the president of the United States of what's that he's got that phone. That's not just the act of a lunatic, although it is. I said not just the act. No, but I mean, but it's also it's meant to send a signal.
He's trying to
signal about what kind of what's in that phone and who could be harmed by its partial or full exposure.
We have been in gangster B movie territory for a long time now, and that's where we are.
Are we like C?
Yes, just get in there, wallow around in it. Don't hesitate. That's where we are.
To Hallman's point, when Rudy felt threatened, just momentarily, because this was what, only a couple weeks ago, but it seems like 3 years, by Kurt Volker, he immediately holds up the phone. He's not going to hesitate to hold up the phone when he needs to.
But that also alienates the U.S. attorneys in the Southern District. I mean, there's some poetic justice here. I mean, if you're a prosecutor, the thing you hate is someone who used to head your office, who's violating public law every day in front of everyone. It's like, I'm going to take that guy down. He's besmirching everything that we stand for. So that, I assume, of course, these two guys, they are, you know, Mutt and Joe. Nobody cares about whether they go to jail or not. People will care about if they point the finger at Giuliani, and then if Giuliani is indicted, well, then, you know, the only person he can give up is the president of the United States.
And just to add one more thing to this, just because I find it fascinating, is that, you know, I was talking the other day to Jim Stewart, who wrote the book, the Deep State book, and Jim, who's like one of the great reporters of our age, pointed out something to me that I had told that had flown right by me, which was that when Trump was talking to Zelensky, he does this thing where he says, talk to Rudy or talk to Barr. Right. And that is a very Trump thing to do. He's got these two gigantic egoed lawyers who are both competing for his infection. Mm-hmm. He's throwing them together like a pair of scorpions in a sock.
Which they are. Saying, Barr thinks he's not Rudy, and Rudy thinks he could do Barr's job.
Correct.
So they are structurally.
Structurally, and I believe personally, consider each other rivals. And Trump loves to throw the scorpions together in a sock and see who comes out intact.
Right.
But when you get to things, when things start to get politically and legally dangerous, that kind of thing, which is sort of all fun and games when you're just setting off your underlings against each other for fun and profit, right? But when you start to get into a situation like this and two lawyers like that with degree of power and material information about the president that those two guys have, you are, again, opening yourself up to certain kinds of danger and vulnerability if you're Donald Trump. And that's the kind of thing, like I say, Trump loves to do that, to watch there be chaos underneath them, but it can come back to hurt you later on.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.